This is 2018 Status Update, and we're going to be looking at how a status update on your social media can really change your life. Spoiler alert, while I might give you my opinion on the film, that's no substitute for watching it yourself. Links to the film are in the description. As Kyle walks out to a roaring crowd, he says that he didn't even know how to play hockey a few weeks prior. Then we go back in time to a morning where Kyle's mother begins to barge into his room. She's trying to tell Kyle to wake up so he isn't late on his first day of school. Apparently, they just moved to the area, and he hasn't even finished unpacking. He goes to FaceTime with his father, and we see that he's only with his mother during the school year. After walking in on his grandfather in the bathroom, Kyle makes his way down to the dining room table where his mother and sister Maxie are sitting down to eat breakfast. Kyle isn't too happy with how he's stuck with his mother through his parents' separation, but Maxie tells him that he better get used to it and lose the teen angst. Once at school, he has a day that's anything but good, as he's tricked and laughed at by the popular kids in the school. Soon, he comes face to face with Danny after he hears her singing earlier in the morning. He compliments her singing, but he's quickly cut off by one of the guys that sings with her. Soon, it's lunchtime, and Maxie already has a boyfriend that only speaks Chinese. She's already part of the school. Kyle, on the other hand...
What are you doing at my table?
Wait, no, I'm kidding.
You thought I was serious?
This would be Kyle's new best friend. I was about to say, it's pretty bad when you're even getting pushed around by the unpopular kid. You should really rethink your approach at fitting in if that's your plan. After Lonnie tells Kyle about when he got kicked in his mini Lonnie and pissed himself, he introduces himself officially. And we meet Derek, who comes over and expresses that he isn't happy with the homework Lonnie did for him. Lonnie gives us a quick who's who about Derek, and we see that his girlfriend is named Charlotte, and she's the hottest girl in the school. He explains that Derek is the best hockey player in the school, and Derek proves it when he shoots a milk carton right into Lonnie. Later in the hallway, Kyle has a run-in with Derek and his crew as they shatter his phone while playing hockey with it. I'd say it's safe to say Kyle is the least liked person in that school. I don't even think this counts as hazing anymore. There's a limit, and shattering someone's phone with a hockey stick is a little bit past that limit. Kyle heads to the mall where he finds a phone repair kiosk. When he shows the man his phone, he tells him that his phone is completely ruined. The kiosk man then tells him that he knows about how all the kids have been treating him, and he's just there to lighten the load. The man pulls out a phone that has his own social media app installed on it called The Universe. After Kyle answers what seems to be a redundant question, the man can't help but comment, "This is my new favorite character of all time. Progressive, but raw. Out there, but still clearly in the present. He's just that friend that everyone needs one of at some point in their life." The man explains that all Kyle has to do is fill out the blank status updates, and the positive vibes he puts out there will return to him. That night, Kyle tries to FaceTime his father, but there's no answer. Soon, he hops onto the app and fills out part of the information before posting a status update that says his father and car will arrive in town. The next morning, Kyle goes down to eat breakfast, and his mother tells him that his car's outside. Kyle asks where his dad is, and she assumes that he's still in Cali. Kyle's ecstatic, but he's also curious. That day at school, he asks Lonnie if he ever heard about the Universe app, and Lonnie assures him that he's never heard of it. When he sees that there are auditions for the musical, he gets excited and rushes to the auditorium, where he finds that Danny is the audience watching the audition. In Universe, he posts that he's a classically trained singer, and he rushes into audition. If only it was that simple. The best part of it is that he starts singing opera in front of everyone and blows them away with notes that are actually difficult for classically trained singers to hit. The teacher ends up making fun of him, and Kyle rushes out to find the phone kiosk guy again. Kyle tries to ask him how to take back a past wish, and the guy explains that you can't take back the past. The universe is changing every second, and he tells Kyle that all he has to do is change his status. When Kyle heads back home, he finds that his father is actually there and washing his car. He can't quite explain why he's there, but he is. Soon, his father runs into his mother and starts trying to talk his way back into her life. Once inside, Kyle's father tells a story about surfing all day and night in Cali, and his mother looks as though she's almost disgusted by his behavior. When he goes to toast the family, it seems as though everything's going as well as it can possibly go. Seeing that all this worked, Kyle does what anyone with that sort of power would have done that night. He goes up to his room and sends a lot of status updates out there into the universe. Wouldn't you? What would you wish for if you could update your status like that? The next day, Kyle walks up to the drama teacher and requests another audition. When they just keep making fun of him, he simply rushes over to grab a guitar and starts singing like Bruno Mars in the middle of the cafeteria. Honestly, I'm not even a Bruno Mars fan, but that song hit pretty strongly through this scene. I actually enjoyed it. And it turns into a duet. This version is 1,000 times better. When Kyle finishes his, they head out to eat. And it turns out that he got the part over Brian Massey, the guy that interrupted him and Danny earlier. While they go out and get a drink, Brian actually shows up to fight Kyle. After a quick status update, he proceeds to kick Brian's ass in the parking lot. After he goes home, his father continues to make a fool of himself by being caught in a small lie about getting a job. Kyle's mother and father proceed to disagree about the morality of Kyle fighting, and Kyle ends up leaving everyone at the dinner table to go out with Danny. On his date with Danny, he asks her what she would want to do if she could do anything right now. And she tells him about a nice Ferris wheel ride to enjoy the fall night. Sure enough, Kyle makes a status update, and they come across a Ferris wheel in the middle of nowhere. Does no one in the area question the appearance of a giant Ferris wheel? Like, if they aren't included in the moment, do they see it? After Lonnie gets jealous of how popular Kyle's become in such a short amount of time, Kyle tells him about the Universe app. But Lonnie isn't too much of a believer. As a way to try to convince Lonnie, Kyle posts a status update saying that Lonnie's a skateboard pro. And sure enough, Lonnie starts skating just like a pro. Soon after, he actually does an awesome thing that doesn't require a status update. Once he finds out that Danny writes music, he actually convinces the chorus teacher to listen to the song so he can change the song they sing at the competition to her song. Afterwards, she explains to Kyle that he's the only one that could have convinced her to sing her own work. And the two of them then almost share their first kiss. That would have been too easy and too early. That day at lunch, Kyle and Lonnie still get bullied by Derek. And Lonnie has this awesome idea that Kyle should try out for the hockey team and beat him at his own game. Well, Kyle ends up liking that idea. And after a quick status update, he heads to the hockey practice to show off some skills. It turns out that he wasn't quite specific enough about his wish. And he ends up figure skating. After a quick adjustment on the app, he makes the team without any issues. And Derek ends up spending his time on the bench. After seeing her boyfriend spend the game on the bench, Charlotte doesn't seem at all happy about the change in the status quo. When Danny comes up to Kyle to check on him, she reminds him that he missed rehearsals that morning, and Kyle promises that he'll figure out a way to make it work with both. That evening, Kyle goes to hang out with Lonnie, and the hockey team shows up with the girls to celebrate their win. After they get Kyle to come over and hang out with them, Lonnie heads out while Charlotte makes the moves on Kyle. That Friday, Kyle heads to a party that Charlotte invited him to, and Kyle's immediately the highlight of the party. After Derek comes over in a drunken stupor, Charlotte comes over and takes Kyle away from the rest of the party. Meanwhile, Lonnie waits with his parents for Kyle to show up to his one friend birthday gathering. Lonnie's parents even think Kyle is another one of Lonnie's imaginary friends. Poor kid finally thinks he has a real friend. He got his hopes up just enough to have them fall right back down. Back at the party, Charlotte explains that the only part of the perfect recipe that he doesn't have in the school is her. And she makes him choose between her and Lonnie. While they inevitably make out, she snaps a picture and puts it up on her social media. When they go back to school, Danny isn't happy with what she saw on Charlotte's platform, and she tells him that he's just the new Derek. After a terrible practice, Kyle tries to talk to Lonnie about using the Universe app to become whoever he wants to be. And Lonnie assures him that he's exactly who he wants to be. Little do they know that Brian is eavesdropping, and here's enough. That night, Kyle shows up to eat dinner with Charlotte's parents. And her father makes it very clear that Kyle will never be one of them. After Kyle goes back to the bathroom, a status update quickly changes the demeanor of both Charlotte's parents. Well, I'll be damned. Then Kyle looks terrified. She looks like she's about to tear him apart and shove him in the fridge. When Kyle goes to post a status update to change how Charlotte's parents feel about him, he ends up breaking his phone badly enough that the app doesn't work anymore. Quickly, he gets to his car and escapes the nightmares he's created. He heads for the mall to try and catch the phone kiosk before the mall closes, but the security guard informs him that they've never had a shopping kiosk in that mall. When Kyle gets home, he hears his mother and father fighting again, and he finds out that his father isn't quite what he thought he was. He finds out that his father didn't actually want him to stay with him, and his mother didn't rip him away from his father. The next day, Kyle and Danny try to sing her song at rehearsals, but she can't stand to sing with him anymore. She goes to quit, but Kyle realizes it's him that should quit instead. That evening, Kyle goes to the pep rally for the hockey team, and he gets pulled up front to give a speech to his classmates. The second he goes to speak, Brian comes on stage to call him out for being fraudulent. Brian brings up the magic app on his phone, and the crowd assumes that he's just crazy and jealous. Honestly, how else did he really think that was gonna go? Magic phone app? No, that's pretty much it for his social life. What's even better that Kyle actually tells Danny about all of it too. She just rubs salt into his wounds when she mentions that she wrote that beautiful song the day after he took her to the Ferris wheel. The next morning, Kyle tells his mother that he doesn't want to go to school, and he explains everything in a basic sense that doesn't make him sound crazy. His mom tells him that he just needs to face everyone that he's hurt and get it over with. When he comes down to eat breakfast with the family, he faces his father about how much he put him on a pedestal, only to realize that he didn't belong there. Maxie apologizes for being a lousy sister, and Kyle makes his way to Lonnie's house where he introduces himself to Lonnie's parents to prove that Lonnie really does have a real friend. When they hear the news, Lonnie's mother's overjoyed. But when Lonnie comes down the stairs, he brushes right by Kyle. After skating to school, the two of them mend the bridge that Kyle was worried was burnt down. Once at the school, Kyle ignores Charlotte to go sit with Lonnie at the reject table. Kyle tries to tell him that he doesn't want to be this guy anymore, and he just wants to get Derek back to where he belongs. Meanwhile, at rehearsals, something's wrong with Dani as she sings, and she realizes that she wrote the song as a duet, and it doesn't sound right anymore. When Kyle comes in, he hears that they're going back to the same old song they had before. Charlotte asks why Kyle's been ignoring her, and he promises that he isn't. After Charlotte makes her love for him very apparent, she wishes him luck at the game that night. That night, Kyle prepares to start the game when he sees that all of Kyle's important people have shown up, except for Dani. Even Charlotte's parents are there to share how much they love him. Shortly after the face-off, Kyle gets hit so hard that he gets injured. Coach tries to put him back in the game, but Kyle just says he can't do it. Then, Derek tells the coach to put him in the game in Kyle's place. And when he walks by Kyle, Kyle winks. After Kyle gets taken to the locker room for his injury, Lonnie comes in and helps Kyle make it to the school for the big singing competition before Dani goes on. Just as they start to sing Hallelujah, Kyle shows up to play Danny's original song. I know they're playing it up that Hallelujah is an old, boring, depressing song, but I personally love that song. Especially after hearing it in Shrek. Yeah, that long ago. After a marvelous display, Dani asks Kyle why he's there, and he finally apologizes for how he's been treating her for some time now. After they take a bow, the lights shut off, and Kyle's phone rings. When he sees that the Universe app is asking if he wants to delete it, he happily says yes, and he can't believe that it worked. When he turns to Dani to tell her that he got his life back, she doesn't seem ready to get back to who they were. When Kyle goes outside, Charlotte breaks things off with him, and his real friends all show him their support. When Kyle spots his father who's there to say goodbye, he heads over to hear that he's really leaving. As Kyle says goodbye to his father, his mother checks to see if he's doing okay, and he doesn't see why he wouldn't be. Back at school, almost everyone shows Kyle the normal love he had hoped for in the beginning, but Dani still won't give him the time of day. Suddenly, Dani comes back to tell Kyle she's happy she met him, and the two of them share their first kiss as Kyle lifts her up. So this was a very predictable film. Nothing super crazy different, but it's a tried and true formula that works. Everyone needs that feel-good movie every now and then, and this was a pretty solid one. Worth a shot if you're looking for a feel-good movie. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more like this one. Comment what you think I should watch next, and I'll see you in the next video.